Ja, über was rede ich heute? Ich rede heute über die mentalen Modelle von Schülerinnen und Schülern, über das Thema Informatik, und dafür haben wir eine sogenannte Rich Picture Analysis durchgeführt. Was das ist, da sage ich gleich noch was zu. Als allererstes eine Sekunde. Die Agenda, die ich mitgebracht habe, zuerst werde ich das Thema motivieren. Warum haben wir diese Studie durchgeführt? Was sollten wir damit herausfinden? Ich werde ein bisschen was zum theoretischen Hintergrund von der Arbeit erzählen. Dann werde ich die Studie und die entsprechenden Ergebnisse zum Thema Interesse und mentale Modelle zum Thema Informatik von Schülerinnen und Schülern vorstellen und kurz noch über die Implications sprechen. Die Motivation ist, glaube ich, den meisten Leuten hier klar, warum man sich dieses Themenfeld anguckt. Wir haben eine große Nachfrage nach Experten im Bereich STEM, beziehungsweise im Deutschen heißt es halt MINT, also Mathematik, Naturwissenschaft, Informatik und Technik. Und wenn man sich angucken kann, was man dagegen machen kann, ist halt das allererste, dass man versucht, die Partizipation von Frauen deutlich zu steigern, weil da die Partizipationsquote, das haben wir heute Morgen schon im Vortrag gehabt, irgendwo bei 18% liegt und die mit zunehmendem Qualifikationsniveau auch in der Regel weiter abfällt. Es gibt zahlreiche unterschiedlichste Initiativen, um diesen Gender Gap im MINT-Bereich oder im STEM-Bereich zu adressieren. Die entscheidende Frage ist allerdings, wie müssen die aufgebaut sein und wann sollten die am besten einsetzen? Kurz zum theoretischen Hintergrund. Wir haben uns verschiedene Sachen angeguckt. Eine Sache, die in der Literatur häufiger vorkommt, ist die sogenannte Selbstwirksamkeitserwartung, eine Theorie von dem Psychologen Bandura, die sagt, wenn wir irgendwie ein bestimmtes Verhalten ausführen wollen, hängt das im Wesentlichen davon ab, welche Erfahrungen haben wir gemacht. Now I will switch back to English. That's no problem, I have English the slides and I can also try to speak in English a bit.
I can leave.
I know, it's no problem. It's an honor. And the self-efficacy theory states that your choice of action, your performance in these actions, and also your endurance in these actions is determined by your personal experience, prior experiences, the observation of role models, for example, also the social support by others, and also your own individual physiological reactions while doing a specific activity. And this is an integral part of, for example, the social cognitive career theory by Lent, and, well, relates to what kind of jobs we will select after our school education, for example. And a second aspect we looked at are mental models. What is a mental model? It's basically a small-scale representation of our real world. And these small-scale representations help us in information processing and in decision-making. And they can be really useful if they're correct, but they can lead us in the wrong direction if they're wrong. And a very early study on mental models was conducted by Margaret Mead and Metro. And they studied what scientists look like in the eyes of children. It was not computer scientists, but general scientists. And one of the findings was that a scientist is a man who wears a white coat and works in a laboratory. He is elderly or middle-aged and wears glasses. He is small, sometimes small and stout, or tall and thin. He may be bald, he may wear a beard, may have unshaven and unkempt. He may be stooped and tired. And what's also quite interesting is if you look here, I mean, it was the 50s, they asked, if you're a boy, how do you imagine how you would be like as a scientist? And then if you're a girl, how would you imagine how you're as a scientist, or if you marry a scientist? So also a slight gender bias here, but it was the 50s. So in our work, we wanted to address four research questions. First, we wanted to understand if gender influences computer self-efficacy and the interest in computer science, and we selected sixth graders for our studies. We wanted to understand what the mental models of sixth graders are in regard to computer science, and we wanted also to understand if gender influences these mental models. And also, as the last research questions, we ask ourselves whether self-efficacy influences mental models as well. As a method, we frequently conduct robotic workshops for children. And these children are usually from the sixth grade. And in this case, we have a mixed gender setup. So we have boys and girls in the classes. And we measured several variables in our study. So the first was obviously gender, and also self-efficacy in interacting with technology on a validated scale, and as well as interest in computer science. And on the last page of the questionnaire, we asked school students to draw a person who is working in the area of computer science. Now, the sample description from our study, we had children from three different schools and four different classes. And in total, we had 113 children, about gender balanced. And from the 113 questionnaires, we collected 99 contained drawings. So, first are the results. When we look at the effect of gender on self-efficacy in interacting with technology and interest in computer science, we see a significant effect of the gender, and the boys report a higher self-efficacy in interacting with technology, as well as a significantly higher interest in computer science. And then, as already mentioned, we asked the students to draw a person working in computer science, and also already told 99 images were submitted. And this is not a completely new method. There are already a few articles around that evaluated mental models and drawings of children, but usually they're for general scientists and not specifically for the area of computer science. So, this is one of the images from a child. A sad little person with a computer in his head, some kind of thought bubble, I guess it is called, with a formula in it, and a t-shirt, "I love computer science." But also a different image like this one, with a computer in the background and a tough lady in the foreground. And now I have a few more images, like this one. It says, "Ein normales Mädchen," a regular girl, and "Informatik" on computer science on the t-shirt. This is another image. Here you see a slightly weird looking man and an open computer with which should be stereotypical for computer science, of course. And then we have this guy here with, again, a thought bubble and a lightning bulb in it, which indicates some strike of genius or something like this. Another image is this here, lots of formulas, so it must be very intelligent, but also a bit distance, I guess. And you see also computers, a laptop, or whatever. And then we have this sad looking girl with nerd on the t-shirt. And this one, we had this already, right? So I can show you hundreds of these images. We have, oh no, I can't, I have 99 pictures only. But just looking at the images doesn't really make sense. So we wanted to have some numbers to play around and to evaluate and to understand the mental models of the children. So what we did is a so-called rich picture analysis. That is, we asked several raters to rate the images along several scales. The scales were the first, is there an image included? So not everybody draw an image, but one kid wrote, "I hate drawing." So this wasn't counted as an image. Then we asked our raters to evaluate whether the image is more of a man or more of a female person. The mood of the images, the situation, this is a rather social or rather unsocial situation. And we also ask for the attractiveness and the perceived intelligence of the persons, or whether it is geeky or not geeky. We had in total 9 evaluators from 25 to 38 years. 5 were male and 4 were female, and 6 had a background in STEM, and 3 without a STEM background. The first thing we found out was that the raters were very consistent in their evaluation, so they were basically always thinking the same about the images.
But these were adult raters, right?
Sorry?
They're adult raters.
yeah, adult raters from the STEM domain and not from the STEM domain. So it was mixed, basically. Yes, please. Yeah, exactly. Maybe I didn't explain this enough. So this was a small application we wrote for evaluating the images, and the evaluators rated each of the 99 images. And there are sliders, and you had to select whether it is more male or more female, the image.
That's interpretation from the rating.
Yes, exactly. What do you mean by a reflection? So we had 9 raters, and the raters more or less agreed on whether it is a rather, yeah. Yeah, you're right, but as we had multiple raters from both sexes and different technological backgrounds, I think this can be somehow ruled out a bit. And if not, please contact me. I give you the images, and you're free to reevaluate them. So these are the results. So here we have a metric scale, basically, and you see that the majority of the images was more towards the male direction. You also see that the images depict a rather negative mood, not very social situations, but on the other hand, all the people were drawn as rather attractive and also as rather intelligent and as rather geeky. Now, when we look at the next question was whether there's a gender effect on the drawings. And one thing I forgot. What we did, we also calculated we decided whether the image are more male and more female, and we just counted them. So 13 were rather indecisive about the middle, and 19 showed more female images, and 67 more male images. So in regard to the gender effects, we noticed that the boys draw significantly more men, nearly only men, and the girls drew about equally often male and female scientists. And the boys' drawings were perceived as significantly less positive than the female drawings, and we also noticed that the girls' drawings are perceived as significantly more intelligent. So let me get back to the research questions from the beginning. The first question we wanted to understand is if gender influences the computer science efficacy of school children and also the interest in computer science. And we can say, yes, this was true because of the significant differences I've shown earlier. We have shown some mental models of the school children on computer science. And we could also show that there are significant gender differences in regard to the mental models of computer scientists. What we were not able to show, and I wrote a few sentences in the article, I didn't present this here, we also wanted to show whether self-efficacy relates to the images as well, and we weren't able to show this clearly. I have this in the limitation, so here's the question mark on this question. Let me come to the summary and the conclusion of this work. We see that girls report a lower technical self-efficacy and a lower interest in computer science, and this impacts the career decision even at that age. We have also seen that the images are predominantly male and are perceived as rather intelligent and less social. And I conclude that the lower interest and computer science may relate to this ill-aligned mental models of the school children. And we also see that the gender differences emerge at the age of 13 or 14 years, so it's from the sixth grade, and this means that we need to start with interventions against this gender differences even at an earlier age, maybe even at kindergarten, for example. And what we also should do is that our interventions we developed, they should also address the mental model. So for example, we should present some role models, some positive role models, maybe also female role models. And as you have said in the keynote this morning, maybe not the role models that are so far away, but maybe local role models. What are the limitations of the study? Well, the biggest limitation, in my opinion, is that we have only one picture taken by the school children, and we also asked for a noun, so draw a person who's working in this area. I think we should have focused on an activity, draw a person doing something, being in a meeting, for example. This would have been, I think, a bit more interesting than what we have done here. And future research ideas that we have is to increase the picture space by asking for different activities and also to contrast our study across different disciplines. So how is a computer science scientist different from a person working in social science, for example? And then what we also want to do is to link this rich picture analysis with other personality states and traits. We tried this with the self-efficacy, but it didn't work out in our study. But this probably because we just asked for the person and not for an activity. And this concludes my talk. Thank you very much for your attention. And I'm here for questions.